to everything we hold dear as America. We are a nation founded on the truth that all of us are created equal. We are equal in the eyes of our Creator. We are equal under the law, and we are equal under our Constitution. Those who spread violence in the name of bigotry,
they're even open to question. And this is so obvious, and this is so easy. And when you blame the fake news media for being mean to you because you made a bad statement on Saturday, by the way, the reports are that there was a second statement that he had in front of him on Saturday that was exactly the same as the statement he made yesterday. He went off cuff because he didn't actually want to discuss the white supremacy on Saturday. And there was that report that came out yesterday. It's not good stuff. Who are sort of part of the alt-right and alt-right friendly base, it does not help his case that he's trying to separate off from this group. And he should be separating off from this group, okay? It's an immoral group. It's an immoral group. And it's not that everyone who likes memes, everyone who tweets memes, is a member of the alt-right. I discussed this yesterday. But the alt-right has effectively used the internet to seize the high ground of sort of meme territory. And it's a way to spread the word. A member of the alt-right, and the vast majority of people who like memes are not members of the alt-right. But this is how the alt-right recruits. This is how the alt-right seduces. They say we're just being dissidents and trolling, and we're tweeting out anti-Semitic and racist memes, and it's because the left can't take a joke that they don't like your stuff. Not because they don't like racism or anti-Semitism, but because they can't take a joke. And that is not in any way in the right.
You as an African-American parent will not say that.
Well, it's not a thing to try to pull my black card. I am well aware of my blackness and don't need you to try to classify me as being one. I understand what race
are you?
Please don't go there. Do not go there. I know what it means to be a black man in this country. I know and I experienced racism on a regular basis by being a Trump being a proud American.
Okay, so for things I like today, I want to do an oldie but a goodie because it's I think almost indicative of where we've gone as a country. These two books that I'm about to talk about. So Harper Lee wrote one of the great American classics, of course, To Kill a Mockingbird, and it is a phenomenal book. It is a truly phenomenal book. I remember reading this book, I think I was probably 9, To Kill a Mockingbird for the first time, concert, which helps normalize bigotry in our community. Prager's a right-wing radio host who promotes horribly bigoted positions. Dennis does not promote horribly bigoted positions, of course. It's just another demonstration that the left attempts to lump everyone in with the alt-right, and that's why it's so important both that the left stop doing that and that the right actively separate itself from the alt-right and from the racists who would hang around the fringes and be important members. At the rally, was photographed wearing an Arkansas engineering shirt, and amateur investigators found a photo of Quinn that looked something similar. That was enough to go after Quinn, and they basically ruined his life. People demanded he lose his job, people accused him of racism, people posted his home address on social networks, he and his wife stayed with the cops. Again, the fever pitch in this country pours for several years now, particularly OAN. One of the shows that I used to enjoy watching a lot more on ESPN was Pardon the Interruption with Tony Kornheiser and Michael Wilbon. They're both really clever guys. They know a lot about sports. I used to be a big fan of the show, but now it seems like it's just two lefties going back at each other on every topic under the sun. Really boring. It's absolute nonsense. But again, this sort of politicization drives people to the alt-right. Okay? It drives people to the extremes. Whenever you have politicization of what are common topics, it drives people insane and drives them to the extremes of politics. It's a bad thing. We should have social fabric where we can come together. The national anthem seems like one place we should be able to come together. Watching football games seems like another place we should come together. If even these last tiny and almost of commonality are ripped away from us, it's pretty clear that